Hi, I'm David Connor. I'm the head of midwifery here at UCLH. I've been a midwife for just over 20 years now. I'm originally from Northern Ireland, moved to London back in the 90s, trained as a nurse, started a placement in midwifery, and after I had my first delivery, I was hooked. That was the profession for me.
My name is Deborah Kroll. I'm a community midwife. I retired in 2020 and then came back 2 days a week on a retire and return scheme. I've been a practicing midwife for 41 years. So I trained at St. Thomas's and Guy's Hospital. I arrived from South Africa and Guy's and Tommy's were one of the first hospitals that were prepared to take me. St. Thomas's had an arrangement with University College Hospital, which at the time was not a teaching hospital. So we did our training between the two hospitals, Guy's and Tommy's, 1 year's experience, and then they sent us to UCH where there were no student midwives, so we could basically get our feet on the ground and run.
My name is Yemi Ayilanro. I currently work on labor ward as a midwifery sister labor ward coordinator. I have been a midwife for over 20 years now and well experienced.
My name is Rashida Sani Abdul Salam. I'm a midwife, band 6, and I've been a midwife for 7 years.
Hello, my name is Meg Wilkinson. I'm a consultant midwife here at UCLH. I trained to be a midwife 29 years ago in Hertfordshire at the University of Hertfordshire. I was a nurse before I became a midwife.
I think the biggest difference in midwifery since I qualified is the advancement in technology. So if a lady books for maternity care now, all her notes are on her phone. Here at UCLH we have a MyCare app, which is just amazing. We're able to update our ladies and them to carry their notes around with them all the time. Back when I trained, it was a large book that they had to carry around with them, an all handwritten paper documentation.
The biggest difference is the number of women who now come through who would not have had babies when I qualified. So midwifery was relatively straightforward when I qualified. We were very clear of boundaries. We did low risk, obstetricians did high risk, but we looked after everybody. We had much smaller numbers. I think the advent of IVF happened while I was training. I think Louise Brown is about 40 years old. And IVF and the ability of women with medical complications to become pregnant and maintain a pregnancy safely and deliver has changed a lot.
I think the biggest difference since I've trained is that it's become increasingly more busy. More people are coming into hospital with complex cases, and in the past these women would have probably been encouraged not to have babies, so that's quite interesting to see, and it's more inclusive, and it's great to see, you know, everyone having the opportunity or possibility to become mothers.
The biggest difference I've noticed since I qualified is the amount of paperwork that midwives do. We seem to write copious notes compared to what we did before, which makes the job of a midwife much more challenging when we're looking after women on the labour ward.
Story is a bit cheesy, but I wanted to become a midwife because I've always loved babies. I come from a really big family, but it was only after I spent a summer when I was 16 years old at home, not being very active, but I watched this, it was an American program called Maternity Ward on Discovery Home and Health. And I just thought, this is amazing, because I've always been a feminist. I've always wanted to work with women and for women. And I thought, what better profession, you know, could I actually achieve this? And this is a profession that could take me international. And I've always loved traveling, and I still travel a lot. So that's why I wanted to become a midwife.
I didn't. I did not want to become a midwife. I hated gynecology as a nurse. I trained in South Africa during the height of apartheid, and I was a very stroppy nurse, student nurse, and I was constantly in trouble. And in order to do anything in South Africa, you had to do midwifery. So we had little pips on our shoulders. So once you're qualified, you've got a band on your shoulder and you've got little pips, a bit like the army, depending on what your qualifications were. I wanted to do genetics and I was told I hadn't done a BSc nursing, I hadn't done midwifery, so there was no way they were going to let me do genetics. By that stage, I was starting to get into trouble politically. I was doing things that the matrons, who were very, very stalwart, pro-apartheid, didn't like us doing. And so they started making threats that they would take midwifery and they would take, I think it was mental health at that stage, yes, mental health nursing. And they would take all our experience away from us, so we couldn't leave the country. So I decided that I would, for the short time I'd left, I would shut my mouth, finish my training and leave for England. I was lucky I had an aunt who had done the same as me 25 years before, so I could come here. And I got here and I did midwifery and I had the most amazing training. Fell in love. I learned what it meant to be with women, which is what the word midwife means. I learned what it was very quickly to work across a multitude of ethnicities, women with very different beliefs, very different ways of living. My 41 years will tell you that I was probably a midwife at the end of what is currently called the TV show called The Midwife. And we used to get on our bicycles with hats on our heads and capes on our backs before mobile phones, before sonic aids. And I just fell in love with it. It was just the most wonderful thing I'd ever done.
I'd say do it. It's the most exciting career that is out there. Every day is different. And there's so many options and opportunities to branch out into different areas of practice. It's never dull, never boring. I don't regret it for one moment.
I would say to them to be very kind. I would advise them to be patient. Sometimes we look after women at the end of the day for a whole 12 hours and we see that when we go, this woman delivers. So we have to be a good listener. Respect the women and the family, we have to be very supportive. So that's all you need to become a good midwife.
Definitely speak to a midwife. And if you can, try and get some experience in a clinic setting, a hospital setting, as a volunteer. I think that would probably be the best piece of advice I could give.
My advice to anyone who would like to become a midwife is to follow your dreams and go for it. It's hard work. Not gonna lie, it is hard work, but it is the most rewarding job you could ever do. You are with women at their most vulnerable time, but they are transitioning to become mothers, which is amazing.